সেটা না আসার আসলে আমি je to jenom tak volně. Aspoň jsem do toho nějakou muziku a jenom abyste viděli styl soubojů v té naší hře. Viděl se snažíme do cíle. Pojď.
Getaway driver, what do you think?
All right.
So, fellas, come on, tell me. What's going on at the hotel? Come on, I won't tell anyone.
What are you writing, a book? I already told you everything you need to know.
Hey, I'm just curious, you know?
Marty, all the secrecy is important. The less you know, the better off you are.
If you keep asking questions, I'm just gonna have to find somebody else to drive us next time.
Okay. Look, no more questions. I promise. Okay? So, you're gonna blow the hotel sky high, huh?
Marty!
Sorry.
One more word out of you.
All right, sorry. Not another word. Cross my heart.
Welcome, GameSpot readers, to the E3 demonstration of Mafia 2. My name's Denby Grace, I'm the producer, and I'm going to walk you through today's demonstration. Anyway, we don't have much time, so we're going to jump right in. Here we are in a diner in Empire Bay. This guy in front of us is Vito Scaletta. He's the main protagonist in Mafia 2. He's the player character. You know, our game has an epic story, and it spans 10 years of Vito's life. From where we are today in February 1945, all the way to the mid-1950s. Now, Vito is an Italian-American immigrant. He's from a very poor upbringing. And this very poor upbringing is what drives this guy to sort of, like, be pushed to a world of organized crime. So where we are right now in the demonstration is we're halfway through a mission. Now, we're going to go take the scenic route on the way to that mission so I can give you a few more details about the location where this game actually takes place. So the city that the game is based in is called Empire Bay. It's a fictional US city, but it has its inspiration in real US cities from the era. And it's roughly 10 square miles in size and features some 20 diverse different neighborhoods. That's about double the size of the city of Lost Heaven from Mafia 1. The neighborhood we're driving through right now is a place called Sand Island. It's a poor, run-down, desolate area. And if we were down in some of the more wealthier part of town, such as downtown area, we'd see a very different picture indeed. Things like shops, restaurants, all these different things that you'd expect to see as you would in any real city. So the other thing that you're probably recognizing and seeing right now that you've not seen before in any of the Mafia 2 gameplay footage is obviously the first part of the game, as I said, it's February 1945, is played against this winter backdrop. Now, whilst the winter looks very cool, it also feeds into our narrative very well. The start of the game is a pretty bleak time for Vito. He's just returned from the war in Europe. As I've already said, he's penniless and actually he's injured. You know, like I said, it's bleak, you know, and small details like this throughout the game sort of play in and strengthen our narrative. Now, as well as the winter being very cold and looking very nice and playing into this narrative, it also has gameplay implications as well. You know, our driver here, he's doing a very good job of keeping the car on the road, but as you can see, you know, sliding these 40s vehicles around in these icy conditions is really fun and exciting thing to do. And it's these small details that really make Empire Bay come alive. You know, it's the war propaganda on the billboards. It's the clothing that people are wearing. It's these authentic 1940s vehicles that you can see driving around today. All of these small details really make Empire Bay come alive and be this key character in the game. Almost as key as, say, Vito or Joe, the leading characters in our game, actually are. Anyway, at this point, we're making good progress towards this mission's actually going to take place. So I fill you in a bit of background and a bit of context so you know what the hell's actually going on. At this point in the Mafia 2 main story, Vito's a nobody as far as the mob's concerned. You know, he's just a hired gun. He's not a made man or anything like that. So Vito's actually been hired to perform a hit on a guy called the Fat Man. Now, the Fat Man, he runs a distillery here up on the left. And the Fat Man is running this distillery on Mafia turf. He's repeatedly been asked to pay his protection money, but he's blatantly refusing. So everyone knows what Mafia folklore dictates, that eventually, if you refuse to pay your protection money, someone like Vito will come around and ask for it, and invariably the results are never pretty. So Vito's making his way up these stairs here to this apartment to meet up with his accomplices, Henry and Joe. I'm going to shut up now and let you see how this all plays out, as it gets quite noisy now. Thank you for joining me here on GameSpot today. Hope you enjoyed what you saw. And now, look out for the rest of the game early in 2010.
Where you from, Henry?
Sicily.
What brought you to the States?
Mussolini.
Will you buy you a ticket?
Don't be a smartass, Joe. My father was a man of honor. Things got pretty bad for us after Mussolini came into power. My old man figured I'd either get drafted or locked up. So he sent me to America and got me a job working for Pimenti.
So what happened to your father?
He said he was too old to make the trip. Mussolini had him arrested, and he died in jail. They won't even turn his body over for a proper burial.
That's rough.
So So how's your English so good?
They're coming. Those black cars. Vito, aim for the fat bastard. We gotta nail him before he gets in the building. Get ready.
All right, I'm on it.
All right.
They got guns up there in the window.
That's him, Vito. Wait, that fat. Can't let that fat bastard get away. Okay, you first, Vito. You're the war hero. Go, go, we'll cover you.
We're coming for you, Porky. The button, Vito.
What the hell are you doing, Joe?
Well, thirsty. Pretty good stuff. You should try it.
I'm leaving you to be drinking on the job.
Come on, Porky's upstairs!
kill me! Please! I got a wife!
You should have thought about your wife before.
I don't do anything you want! Just stop killing me! Oh, for Christ's sake!
Don Clemente sends his regards. Oh!
Please, don't make me do this.
Henry, you okay? Where'd he hit you?
Of course I'm not okay. He shot me in the neck.
You're right. Son of a bleeding all over the place.
Get me to El Greco.
The painter?
No, the doctor,
okay,
you
take it easy. We're gonna get you there in a minute.
The Greek guy lives up in Highbrook.
Let's get you to the car.
You're heavier than you look.
I almost shot my balls off.
Take it easy. You missed him by a mile. Careful, Vito. There's probably more of these bastards in here somewhere. Hey, careful! This hurts.
Yeah, well, you can walk if you don't quit your moaning.
No, please. I don't want to die.
Stay with me now.
Yeah.
What?
I got the road blocked off.
Oh.
Vito, just drive.
Get out of the vehicle immediately, or we will open fire.
Take it easy, will you, Henry? Relax. It's under control.
I got a hole in my leg the size of a bull, Dean. You're telling me it's under control?
You're gonna have a hole in your head pretty soon if we don't get out of this. Vito, do
the cops. Doctor, no!
You ain't even gonna give me a tip?
You want a tip? I'll give you a tip. Don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out.
Always the gentleman, huh, Joey?
Just get the fuck out of here,
Vito, hon. Wow, how could a chick so loose be so uptight? What's taking so long, Vito?
Hey, Vito, pick that up, will you?
Yeah, I got it. Yeah, Joe's place.
Vito, is that you? Giuseppe here. I've been looking for you. I got these special papers for you here. They're all done.
So long,
great, I'll stop by.
Baby,
thanks, sorry, Giuseppe.
All right, what do you want me to say?
Okay, ciao, Vito.
All right, I gotta go see Giuseppe. I'll see you later.
All right, I'll see you later.
Hey.
Hey, Steve.
Hey, you want to make a quick buck? I got something that needs doing.
Maybe.
Derek wants me to take care of some, cars.
Cars, huh?
Yeah, you know the, thing Derek's got going with the cars, right? Well, some asshole's been giving him some competition, and that ain't good for business.
Hey, Giuseppe. Nice to see you again. So, what do I owe you? Man, you don't gotta pay nothing, don't worry. It's a gift from Joe. Oh, that's great. Thanks. You're welcome. Ecco qua. The best tools in the city. It's a really useful little tool. The most powerful handgun in the world. Anything else I can do for you? Come back again soon, Vito.
All right, here we go.
What's up, fellas? What are you guys, lost?
Shut up and fuck over all your dough before you get hurt.
Is this enough?
Oh, okay, wrong guy. We got you.
Oh, easy, pal.
Hey, what the hell's going on here? All right, you. You better hope you got a permit for that thing. Let's see it. Hey! Stop!
Okay, here we go.
you looking for? Are you looking for a new set of wheels? Take your pick, pal. Pick a color, any color.
We understand each other.
Whatever you say, I'll keep my mouth shut.
Hold on. Yeah?
Vito.
Hey, Vito. How are you?
The thing in Millville. It's done.
All right. That's what I want to hear.
It wasn't exactly clean.
Stop hey, already. Please, you mind? Please, no more.
What do you mean?
You know, a couple guys got it.
All right. I could live with that. Come by any time and pick up your money. And who knows, I might have another job for you. Now, where was we?
Tady předvedeme jednu takovou hru, na které děláme, a je to Mafia 2. To, co teď uvidíte, je vlastně demo, který jsme prezentovali novinářům v Kolíně nad Rýnem na veletrhu Gamescom. A dobře, jsou tady nějaký dead slide. A vlastně je to taková zajímavost, že vlastně tahle prezentace, kterou teď uvidíte, je první veřejná prezentace Mafia 2. Živého hraní Mafia 2. Doposud jsme prezentovali veřejně pouze videa, a nebo novinářům se zavřenými dveřmi. A to, co vidíme teď, tak to je první taková premiéra Mafia. Takže asi si nebudu říkat žádný data k tomu. Mafii asi znáte. Pokud ne, tak se stačí podívat do Google, tam najde spoustu informací. Nebo na fan stránky, ano, tady určitě. Takže začneme tím, že si pustíme takový sestřih, co jsme zatím ukazovali právě těm novinářům. Takový různý akční sekvence.
I got a contract that needs some help with.
Who's the lucky guy?
Like a real degenerate bastard, you know that?
Don't kill me! Please, I gotta wait!
Yeah, some operation, eh? Well, don't worry, I thought of everything.
When did you become the smaller?
Since forever. Start the car up, because we'll need to get the hell out of here pronto. Clemente rented the entire 18th floor, third one from the top. There's a couple of suites and conference rooms up there, and guards.
Yeah, how are we gonna get up there?
Round the back, through the laundry room.
What, you wanna wash your shorts before we do this thing?
The meeting? No, the meeting hasn't started yet. We'll find some hotel worker uniforms, then we'll go and clean it upstairs. We'll leave behind the present.
Části Mafie, který jsme ukazovali na veletrhu E3 a na prezentaci tisku. A teď uvidíte vlastně něco úplně jiného. Něco, kde hraje hlavní roli město a takové ne tak akční záležitosti. Takže hurá do toho.
You ain't even gonna give me a tip?
You want a tip? I'll give you a tip. Don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out.
Always the gentleman. Hi, Joey.
Just get the fuck out of here.
Vito, can you come here and wash my back?
Keep it long.
You should say this piece all night.
Takže tohle je Vito Scaletta, hlavní hrdina Mafia 2. Jste předtím viděli Joe'a Barbara, který vlastně...
What's taken so long, Vito?
Jeho kámoš. Momentálně se nachází v Joe'ově víkend.
Hurry it up, Vito, I'm gonna run out of water.
A jak vidíte, tak se trošku užívali. Takže... Dáme si pivko.
Yeah, Joe's place.
Vito, is that you? Giuseppe here. I've been looking for you. I got these special papers for you here. They're all done.
So great, let's go find them. Thanks, Giuseppe.
Okay. Ciao, Vito.
All right, I gotta go see Giuseppe. I'll see you later.
All right, I'll see you later.
Takže teď jsme dostali za úkol zastavit se u Giuseppeho, to je taková hlavní mise. A oblíkli jsme se a můžeme vyrazit.
Come on, baby, I'm sorry, all right? What do you want me to say? Honey, come on, I was out with the fellas last night.
Takže jak vidíte, z bytu vycházíme do dvou. Všimněte si kvalitní textur a míry detailů. Chtěl bych upozornit, že to, co vidíte, hrajeme na testkitu Xboxu, to znamená konzolová verze, která má hodně omezené možnosti. Takže tady máme garáž, protože hra se odehrává ve městě, dost se tam jezdí, takže je důležité, aby hlavní hrdina měl dispozici auta. Takže si tady vybereme nějaký, který jsme si tam uložili dřív do garáže. No, tak třeba tady. A můžeme vyrazit. A co se to tam děje? Naše kamarádka má nějaký problém. Takže...
You're not going anywhere. Can you pay me for this? Help me! Somebody! He's crazy!
Hey, Pat. Knock it off.
Who the fuck are you?
Somebody who doesn't like hearing you talk to a lady like that. So why don't you shut the fuck up and leave while I'm still in a good mood, huh?
What, is she your girlfriend or something? Well, if she's not gonna pay for it, you will.
One word, and you're gonna need a new set of teeth.
Thanks, handsome. I owe you one. You want to come over for some coffee sometime?
Yeah, thanks, but look. I really gotta get going.
You'll like it, I promise. I gotta get going now. I'll see you around.
Takže tady jsme byli svědky takové události, která nám oživuje život ve městě. Ale jak jste slyšeli, nemáme čas. Máme prostě před sebou úkol. Takže hra se odehrává ve městě Empire Bay. Je to fiktivní město, které se zakládá na městech Ameriky. Odehrává se to ve 40. a 50. letech 20. století. Můžete vidět autentické výzdobu ulic. Takže právě se dostáváme k obydlí Giuseppeho, což je takový vysloužilý zlodějíček. Má k dispozici obchod s různými věcmi, Chlapa dělá dokumenty a prodává klíče, takže on pro nás má něco připraveno, takže se to tam jdeme vyzvednout. Takže zas bez jakéhokoliv nahrávání přicházíme.
What are you doing? What's wrong with you?
Patrně radím s tím. Mohl by někdo umřít.
Hey.
Hey, Steve.
Hey, you want to make a quick buck? I got something that needs doing.
Maybe.
Derek wants me to take care of some cars.
Cars, huh?
Yeah, you know the thing Derek's got going with the cars, right? Well, some asshole's been giving him some competition, and that ain't good for business. We gotta take care of it.
You want me to,
Nah, nothing like that. Not yet, anyway. So what do you say? You in? Job pays 500 bucks.
Takže tady vidíme, jak jsou integrované subquesty do hlavní dělové linie, protože my chceme se na ně podívat, takže radím přijme tento úkol.
Sure. All I gotta do.
All right, here's what you're gonna do. You're gonna go to Millville and trash the cars. But don't kill nobody. Derek don't want nobody dead. Yet. Give Derek a call when it's done. I'll see you.
All right, I'll see you.
Takže Derek už byl tak Steve, tam domluvil kšeft.
Hey, nice to see you again. So, what do I owe you? Hey, you don't gotta pay nothing, no more. It's a gift from John. Oh, that's great. Thanks. You're welcome.
Tak jsme si vzvedli ty papíry. No, když jsme tady v tom obchodě, tak se trochu vybavíme.
The best tools
in the city. Molotovy ven, pár.
These are really useful.
Klíče. Takže cíl, jak říkal Steve, je ze Millville. Tam je garáž, někdo tam chce dělat čerty s autama. Takže tam pojedeme a ty auta zničíme, aby si nedovoloval. Je to takový drobný úkol. Takže jsme vybavení. A můžeme jít.
Alright, here we go. What's up, fellas? What are you guys lost?
Shut up and fuck over all your dough before you get hurt.
Is this enough?
Oh, okay, wrong guy, wrong guy.
We got you.
Oh, easy, pal. Hey, what the hell's going on here? Oh, all right, you. You better hope you got a permit for that thing. Let's see it.
Takže zahnali jsme sice lupiče, ale přišel policista, má problém. Chce vidět nějaký povolení, nemáme. Podplácet nebudeme, tak radíme. Zdrhej. Takže tam byl taková věc, policejní hlásič nás zrovna nahlásil naši podobu. Tam nás tam objevila nahoře ikonka, že jsme wanted. To znamená, že kdykoliv nás bude, když nás policie uvidí, tak nás bude rozpoznávat, když nás se rozpozná, tak nás bude zatknout. Takže teď utečeme tady ten dvom, teda jednomu, oni se k tomu přidají. Zbavili policie, teď ještě třeba se zbavit toho statusu wanted. Jsme na daní, takže tady je dobrá příležitost, obchod s oblečením. Takže koupíme si nějaký pěkný hadry.
Did you feel the lining? That's real silk. Here you go.
Tak, krasavec. Tak jak vidíte, ikonka nám zmizela, policie už nás nepozná. Takže, teď jsme se zbavili policie, to je výborné, a teď bychom ještě potřebovali nějaký auto, takže máme paklíče a tam třeba to dělí vzadu. Co radíme? Takže máme několik způsobů, jak vzít auta. Teď tady byli nějací policajti, tak zkusíme ten těžší. A klíčem. Takže šup. Tohle má výhodu, že je to celkem tichý, ale zabere to čas. No tak, no tak. No, tak.
Ok, here we go.
To si užiješ si, neboj. Takže můžeme jet. Slyšíte dobovou hudbu. Co je možná zajímavý, tak tukely na téhle hře hodně záleží, takže pořídili obrovský soundtrack písniček dobových, takže si budeme skutečně moc užívat při častých projížďkách na stranu. Můžeš je trošku rychleji. Město je sice pěkný, ale... Takže teď jdeme do té městské čtvrtí Milville. Takže my vlastně... Co vlastně ukazujeme v tomhle demo, jsou právě ty postraní mise, ty subquesty, jak tomu říkáme. Na čem si hodně zakládáme je to, že ta hra má pořád takovej... průběh, kde vlastně není to přerušovaný nějak drasticky ničím, jak jste viděli, ten subquest plynule navázal a hrajeme ho a vlastně to je takový užívání té hlavní dělové linie. Takže už jsme kousek, nebyl. Tak, teď opatrně. Takže tady máme na radaru, vidíte, tam je to město. Mohli bychom tam dojít různýma způsobama. Zkusíme opatrnou fúzi, protože ve hře používáme i stealth mechaniky. Takže... Probíkáváte takzvaná stupnice neviděnosti. No to říkáme stealth bar. Stealth mechanika snažíme se udělat tak, aby byla hodně taková intuitivní, nějak nesložitá, takže vlastně jdeme jenom potichoučku, pomaloučku, schováváme se. No, takže tady máme hlídače. No tak. Co uděláme? Kdo jste viděli video, tak víte, co se stane. Teď tady máme ty auta, takže co jsme si to nakoupili? No to dobře. Pojď ještě ten druhý. fui tam tak. Takže jednu si tady vezmeme, půjčíme a ujedeme ji. Tohle je taková nejtěžší část té prezentace, protože na hraní to musí skutečně hrát a když je to hodně nachystaný, tak se tady můžou stát hodně divné věci. A tohle není zdaleka nejdivnější. Status, ale tentokrát na auto, protože policajti neví, přesně neviděli Vita, ale všimli si toho auta, takže nahlásili svýma policajníma vysílačkama popis auta a teď vlastně všichni policajti ve městě ví, že to auto hledají a my si nejdřív potřebujeme se jich vybavit, takže možná tady tohle uličko. Snaží ukázat ty destrukce auta, které máme, ale zrovna nebylo v plánu. Vidíte, auto reaguje samozřejmě. Tenhle body shop je dobrý na legalizování aut, ale jak vidíte, co s tím radním udělal, tak první možná by stalo za to trošku opravit. A no, kola nekupuju. Změň barvu, možná značku, ne?
Any color.
Tak to trošku uprav. Motor máme prav ještě? Jo. Tak.
Thanks a lot.
Parádní. No, ta žlutá teda, ten s tou růžovou střechou. Mohl se to vybrat nějak růž. Sedí grafice v té místnosti. Takže jsme ujeli, jak vidíte, ta ikonka už zmizela, policie skutečně nehledá žádný žlutý auto, s růžovou střechou. A teď bych chtěl najít nějakou telefonní budku a zavoláme tomu Derekovi, že je to hotový. Takže... No, opatrně na to kola. No jak vidíte, občas někteří hráči sice se koupí supercharger, ale... Vypadá to špatně. No a teď? Opatrně. No, tak.
Now do we understand each other?
Whatever you say.
Co to bylo? Nevím.
I'll keep my mouth shut.
Hold on. Yeah, Vito.
Hey, Vito. How are you?
The thing in Millville. It's done.
All right. That's what I want to hear.
It wasn't exactly clear.
Stop, hey, Ray, please, you mind? Please, no more.
What do you mean?
You know, a couple guys got it.
All right. I could live with that. Come by any time and pick up your money. And who knows, I might have another job for you. Now, where was we?
Tak jo, tak tohle je to demo, který jsme měli na té výstavě. Určitě jste si všimli, že to vypadá stejně jak ty videa. Je to skutečně záměr, protože na té výstavě jsme to ukazovali asi 80krát, takže je to připravený tak, aby to vždycky vypadalo stejně, aby se nám to nerozbilo. Přece jenom není úplně dobrý, když se tam sejde pět nějakých důležitých novinářů a děje se tam něco úplně jiného. Ale ve hře samozřejmě máme volnost. Takže nevím, kolik mám ještě času, zeptám se tady pořadatelů. Takže máme 5 minutek na dotazy, možná třeba nějaký světlo, mohlo by být. Jestli má někdo nějaký dotaz. Máme 5 minut na odpovědi.
Lace, heart, seem dark, silvery moon is shining through the trees. Cast to me you, sound of kisses floating on the breeze. Act one, be.